إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كلام الله، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. أيها الأحبة في الله، أفضل الذكر لا إله إلا الله، وأفضل الدعاء الحمد لله، وأفضل العمل اتباع سنة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في وقتنا، وأن يبارك لنا في صحتنا، وأن يبارك لنا في أموالنا، وأن يعيننا وإياكم على طاعته، وأن يوفقنا لما يحبه ويرضاه في هذا اليوم الفضيل. My dear brothers and sisters, I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guides us to that which is best and which is He likes subhanahu wa ta'ala, to grant us success in this life and the hereafter, to make and bless our time and our money and our health and our effort and our masjid. My dear brothers and sisters, we just finished the month of Ramadan and we are in a great month, the month of Shawwal, which is one of those great months that is before Hajj. And in this month, we have a great opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about, to prove our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Ramadan, and to prove the love to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we will see in the hadith where Abu Ayyub al-Ansari radiyallahu anhu qala Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستا من شوال كان كصيام الدهر. Anyone who fasts the month of Ramadan and follows it with 6 days of this month, the month of Shawwal, his fasting will be like fasting the whole year. Each hasana is 10 months Ramadan, and then 6 days times 10, 60, that's 2 months, that makes it a full year. So this is an opportunity that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had given to us. I want to reflect on some of the advantages. I know many of us, mashallah, probably already did that. Some of us probably taken Mondays and Thursdays, so it will take the whole month to do that. Some may be slacking until maybe the end of the month and they find themselves missing out on the whole thing. So I want to encourage you, inshallah, and to remind you on the hikmah or the wisdom behind those. Number one, العلماء يقولون نيل الأجر العظيم من صام رمضان ثم أتبعه ستة من شوال كان صومه كصيام الدهر. The huge reward, where when you fast Ramadan in 6 days of Shawwal, it's your fasting your whole life, all the time that you do that, the whole year counts. And you can imagine the reward that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put for the صائمين. إنما يوفى الصائمون أجرهم بغير إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب والصائمون هم الصابرون. فرمضان هو شهر الصبر كما سماه الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم والعلماء. When you talk about the month of Ramadan, it is the month of patience. So fasting is patience. It is actually the absolute patience. The desires that you love the most, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you to refrain from. And the patient people, their reward is innumerable. You cannot count it. So imagine yourself when you fast in the 6 days of Shawwal and fasting the whole life, how rewarding that is. Number two, جبر النقص الذي قد يطرأ على الفريضة. جبر النقص. This is to make up for the shortcomings that you have done in fasting. Some people did not. Some people fasted, but not full credit. Some people fasted, maybe the fast is not accepted. So this will make up for that. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as Tamim al-Dari radiallahu anhu qal, أول ما يحاسب به العبد يوم القيامة صلاته فإن أكملها كتبت له نافلة فإن لم يكن أكملها قال الله سبحانه وتعالى لملائكته انظروا هل تجدون لعبدي من تطوع فأكملوا بها ما ضيع من فريضته. The day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accounts you first salah. If your salah is complete, then mashallah, the rest of the actions will be wonderful. If it's not, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask the angels, does my servant has any optional prayers, nawafil? And then if he has, then he would say, make up for his shortchange in the fara'id with the nawafil. And then he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said at the end of the hadith, ثُمَّ تُؤْخَذُ الْأَعْمَالِ عَلَى حَسْبِ ذَلِكَ, and all the actions will be accounted like that accordingly. Meaning, if your fast is not complete and you have extra fast, it will make up for it. If your zakah is not complete and your extra charity will make up for it, and so forth. So this is another great thing to fast the 6 days of Shawwal. Third one, القرب من الله سبحانه وتعالى ونيل محبة الله سبحانه وتعالى. فالله سبحانه وتعالى في الحديث القدسي يقول ولا يزال عبدي يتقرب إلي بالنوافل حتى أحبه فإن أحببته كنت سمعه الذي يسمع به وبصره الذي يبصر به ويده التي يبطش بها ورجله التي يمشي عليها ولئن سألني لأعطينه ولئن استعاذني لأعيذنه. أشوف الأجر العظيم في نيل محبة الله سبحانه وتعالى في هذه النوافل السؤال والدعاء. عندما تدعو الله سبحانه وتعالى يستجيب لك. When you make extra nawafil like fasting those 6 days of Shawwal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the divine hadith that you continue to draw closer with nawafil until Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you. And if He loves you, one of the great things is your dua is accepted. And if you ask protection, He will protect you. And we have the pandemic that we are facing here with coronavirus and all of that. We constantly make dua and we constantly beg Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us and to heal those who are tested with it and to have mercy on those who died. So picture getting that and gaining the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a wonderful thing to do. Number four, تيسير أداء الفرائض وتمهيدها. تيسير أداء الفرائض. Nawafil makes fara'id easy. The fard becomes easy. If you pray the nawafil that you don't have to do, if you fast the nawafil that you don't have to do, naturally, you're going to be more keen on doing the one that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obliged you to do. And finally, تحقيق صلة العبد بربه في كل الأزمان. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants you to be connected at all times with Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So you need to connect yourself with those things, with those ibadat. It's not like in Ramadan, then we don't know anything about fasting, or when you pray the fard, you don't pray the sunnah, or when you give your zakah, you don't think about charity. Allah wants you subhanahu wa ta'ala to always be connected with Him. أقول قولي هذا واستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا. الحمد لله حمدا يوافي نعمه ويدفع نقمه وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. My dear brothers and sisters, it is indeed a blessing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we are gradually coming back to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It doesn't matter what you do at home or anywhere, it will never equate being in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no doubt that the peace and serenity and rahmah all in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you enter, you say, Allahumma iftah li abwaab rahmatik. This is the door of mercy. You are in the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as one person says, to teach your knowledge is to learn twice. To teach your knowledge is to learn twice or to learn two times. When you pass your knowledge, you are gaining twice, because your knowledge increases when you teach it. And I say to reach out with your fundage is to earn 700 times. And when you reach out to the needy, to the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, with your wealth, you earn 700 times. Reach out to people with your knowledge twice. Reach out to people with your money, you earn 700 times. Brothers and sisters, we're believers, alhamdulillah. And we have reminders, and we are reminded. Ramadan wasn't such a great month to us, being away from the masjid, being deprived from the connection, feeding the needy, and giving for the needy, and donating for the masjid, and witnessing the khair. All of those things we have been deprived from it. Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. We don't complain, but we always prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that everything from Him, and we want to prove that. So brothers and sisters, this masjid of yours, we always give reminders. What do I need from COVID-19, for instance, personally? I need protection. What do I need from Ramadan, or what do I get from Ramadan? Definitely the blessings and the protection. What is one thing in common that fulfills both? It is money. If you donate money, you will prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala your faith, and you protect yourself from the disease. And brothers and sisters, this masjid of yours, it's about $10,000 or so, rent and everything, whether you're here or not. We were not here, but the rent is due every month. You can imagine how much this masjid accumulates. And you can imagine how you and I did not really contribute if the masjid was open before, because we did not come to the masjid. So let's prove to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we love the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We want the house of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to continue to be open and to run. And inshallah, prove that with our charity. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu said, تَتَبَاهَا الْأَعْمَالِ تَتَبَاهَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَتَقُولُ الصَّدَقَةِ أَنَا أَفْضَلُكُمْ. Umar ibn al-Khattab radiyallahu anhu, he said, actions will be bragging or trying to prove who is the best the day of judgment, and charity says, I am the best of you all. Why? Because it proves your faith. It proves your faith. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, was sadaqa burhan. Charity is burhan. And the day of judgment, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asks you, what did you do with this or what did you do with that? The scholar said, the first thing you run to is your charity. I gave for your sake, O Allah, because you give from that you love. وَتُحِبُّونَ الْمَالَ حُبًّا جَمَّا. إِذَنْ يَا إِخْوَانَ خَلِّنَا نشوف إن شاء الله إثبات لله سبحانه وتعالى في هذا الجمع القليل والخير الكثير إن شاء الله اللي يكون فيه. ندعم المسجد إن شاء الله بأقصى ما تستطيع. يعني أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يشارك الجميع على الأقل كل شخص $100 فما فوق إن شاء الله. I beg you, brothers and sisters, to not leave without paying at least $100 to back up your masjid and to pay for the months that we had before, and inshallah to move into the new masjid that we already, alhamdulillah, working on and collecting, and we are very, very, very close. In fact, the brother probably already spoke with the contractor, and we are moving on, inshallah. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يبارك لنا في أموالنا وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجزيكم خير الجزاء وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا وإياكم من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه أولئك الذين هداهم الله وأولئك هم أولو الألباب. اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. وأقم الصلاة.